Hey Canucks fans, we're in day three of training camp and the young guys continue to impress. I'm Clay Emo, I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter. I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCBC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club. This is my Canucks take, all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Tuesday, January the 5th. This is where you get Canucks insight that's positive and timely. Before I get into training camp notes and news, I want to thank everyone for coming out and watching me get pummeled in our live stream last night. Yes, it was a pretty pathetic performance. I didn't score during the tournament, and Sean unsurprisingly won. Jacob came in second and I came in third, but we had a lot of fun in the chat. A lot of people offering to give me tips on how to play NHL 21. I might take some of you up on that offer. So once again, thanks to everyone for joining us last night on the live stream. We had a lot of fun and a lot of compliments about our family dynamic, our interactions between me and my two sons. And I really appreciate that. You guys know, obviously, I love them very much and very blessed by them and my daughter and my lovely wife as well. So thanks again. Make sure you check out only check it out if you want to see how not to play NHL 21. My son Sean is really good, although his competition isn't that good. Speaking of competition, tonight, he's not my competition, but we talk about the North Division competition. I am doing a premiere at 10 p.m. tonight with John Viveros of Hot Take Hockey, and we are previewing the North Division. So make sure you come and watch that as I get rid of that notification for me. Make sure you come at 10 o'clock tonight, and I'll be on there live in the chat box reacting to your reaction to our North Division predictions. Let's talk about Canucks training camp. It's technically day three of training camp, although it's only their second day on the ice because that's on Sunday. We started with medical testing and Green and Benning's press conference. Monday was day two, day one on the ice. Today, Tuesday, is day three, day two on the ice. They kept the same groupings and basically the same line combos and D pairings as yesterday. So that meant, but they reversed it. So group B went first. So that was the group that had the Horvat and Pearson playing with Hoglander of note. And then the second line of that group, maybe the fourth line of the year will be Gaudette, Roussel, and McEwen was their other big line. And then in this group, you do have Hughes and you have Myers and you have Thatcher Demko. So they skated first. And then the second group of group A, which has the Lotto line, which has the Sutter, Virtanen, Mott line, and then you have an Edler Schmidt pairing and Holtby in that group. They skated second. But in between Group B in the morning and Group A in the afternoon, they actually did a quick scrimmage, which Group A won. So that was the team that has P.D. Besser and Miller, Schmidt, and Holtby. And I saw some highlights. You know, it's really good, the good content that's coming out of training camp, because guys like Chris Faber and Jeff Patterson, Brendan Batchelor, Thomas Drantz, Harmon Dial, there's so many people that are there that are tweeting out good stuff, sharing video, sharing sights and sounds and observations. And from all accounts, it sounds like the Lotto line was really good today in the scrimmage, dominating, accounting for at least two or three goals. I know Pettersson got one. I know Besser got one. A nice slap shot from the circles. But I believe it was a 4-1 victory for Group A. Nate Schmidt was very noticeable, doing really well, and obviously Holtby only letting in one goal. But yeah, it's an inter-team scrimmage or whatever, and they're going to do a more simulated game-style scrimmage, where probably longer periods, and they're doing it at night. So the first one will be tomorrow night, Wednesday night, which maybe fittingly is exactly a week away, a week before the night that they open the season against the Edmonton Oilers in Edmonton, on January the 13th. So let's talk about two or three young stars that are making impressions. The first one is Nils Höglander. And I talked about him at length yesterday. I talked about how surprised I was, actually, that he got to line up next to Bo Horvat and Tanner Pearson on the second line. So that speaks, that says a lot of things, as I mentioned yesterday. It speaks to Travis Green's confidence and interest and intrigue level in to see what Höglander can do. The fact that they put him up there with two veterans already, and Höglander, to his credit, did not look out of place. From everything we heard about yesterday and continuing to today, he's skating very well. He's making good passes. He's making good decisions. He's working hard on the back check. All the things that you need to do if you're going to play alongside Horvat and Pearson on the team's second line and basically our shutdown line. So the fact that Travis Green stuck with the same combos both up front and on the blue line for two practices in a row, and then maybe then going to tomorrow night scrimmage. Maybe then they do a quick switch after that for Thursday, Friday. But for now, expect to see the lines that we saw in the 2 days of practice, 2 days of training camp. Expect to see those lines in the scrimmage tomorrow night. So Hoglander, he would be a really, really good bonus. I'm still not convinced he's going to make the team, but if he keeps showing well, you never know. And what was really interesting is Thomas Drance wrote an article for The Athletic talking about how Travis Green on day one of training camp usually makes statements, and he sticks to those statements. And I don't mean verbal statements, I mean statements of who he pairs with who. In 2017, Travis Green's first training camp, he put Godolbin with the Twins. Godolbin just came over from that spring trade from San Jose, and he started the season with the Twins. 2018, he moved Petey from the wing to center, stuck with them, and that, as Thomas Drance said, that could be a franchise-altering move, decision. 2019, from day one, it was Quinn Hughes playing with Chris Tanev on the back end, and we saw that pairing stay together for the whole season. And then 2020, technically 2021, the big move that everyone's talking about was Hoglander playing with Horvat and Pearson. Will that stick? I'm still not sure, but I'd love to be proven wrong. I'd love to see that to start off the season. The other youngster I want to talk about is Olli Juolevi. Given the way that they've paired off, you have Edler with Schmidt, you have Hughes with Chatfield, who many people are saying is kind of like a holding place for Travis Hamonic. And then you have a pairing of Juolevi and Myers, which you could argue is going to serve as the third pair. If Schmidt stays on the right side, which it sounds like he will, you have Schmidt and Hamonic and Myers as your right side guys. And it looks like Myers playing with Juolevi, that's considered the third pair right now. Myers is a little bit an expensive third pairing guy, but it's okay. But the fact that it's Juolevi playing with Myers, it's not Jack Rathbone, it's not even Jordy Benn. In fact, Rathbone and Benn are playing together. They're almost like the 7-8 defenseman, right? The fourth pairing, so to speak. And they'd be the first man up. One of them, if not both of them, will make the opening night roster, at least the team roster, but they might not be skating on opening night, dressing for the game. So it's a same thing as I said about Hoglander, the fact that there's confidence from Travis Green. There's a bit of interest, some intrigue. He wants to see how Juolevi will do as a third pairing guy, and therefore he's playing with Tyler Myers. I think Myers, you know, he's a good veteran. He's a good leader. He'd be a good mentor, and a work ethic, all those things. So I think he'd be, if he ends up being Juolevi's D partner for the season, at least to start off, I think that's not a bad thing at all, especially when you look at the balance on the other two, if it is indeed Hughes and Hamonic, and then Edler and Schmidt. So a lot of us are wanting Olli Juolevi to do well. He was, as we know, our 2016 draft pick, fifth overall. So this is 5 years in now. Yes, we've been patient with him. We know that defensemen take longer to develop, but I think now is the time for Olli Juolevi to step up. And from listening to him talk yesterday and from everything I heard today and saw today, he's doing okay. He got beat on a couple drills, but that's to be expected from a rookie defenseman. Remember, he only played one game in the play-in round at the end of last season. So Olli Juolevi on D, Nils Hoglander up front, the two guys I wanted to talk about today. And I'd love to hear your comments. I know yesterday we talked about Hoglander, and I kind of said I don't think he's going to make the team, although he started well. But if that makes 2 days of him playing well, and then if he does well in the scrimmage tomorrow night, then maybe we're singing a different tune afterwards. So maybe comment on Hoglander, comment on Juolevi, and anything else that you've been reading and seeing from training camp. Two other things. I have a little fun little wager with my friend Louis. Vegas Golden Knights coverage here on Twitter, VGK coverage, and Vegas Golden Knights coverage on YouTube. He's obviously a diehard United States, patriotic American. I'm going for Team Canada in the juniors. So we have a fun little wager. Whoever loses, they'll have to record a fun little video on Twitter, not YouTube, but on Twitter tomorrow. So I'll make sure I mention that, whether I win or lose in tomorrow's video. And don't forget, tonight, that is 10 o'clock, previewing the North Division YouTube premiere, me and John Viveros of Hot Take Hockey. I really hope you will join me tonight at 10 p.m. And I won't be live on screen, but I'll be live in the chat. Okay, Canucks fans, let me know how you're feeling about the team, and specifically about our youth, and specifically about our youth, Nils Hoglander and Olli Juolevi. Leave a comment below. I'd love to read, react, and reply. As always, subscribe if you'd like to. Like this video if you'd like to. Stay safe, stay healthy. Take care of yourselves, and take care of each other. Have a great day. God bless, and go Canucks go.